If you are going to take your bike out on big adventures, many days far out in the bush, you should know how to repair a flat. And to repair a flat, you will need to remove the wheels from the bike and remount it. So that is also why I am now practicing this, and also because I like to change my tires myself. First of all, you have to collect some tools and make a tool list, and take the necessary tools with you out on your adventure. Before we start removing the front wheel, you should pay attention to the ABS sensor. When you are removing the wheel from the bike, be very careful so that you not destroy this ABS sensor. So pay attention to that. If both brake calipers is in place, you will not be able to roll the wheel out from the forks. Next thing to do is to use the 10mm socket to loosen the front axle pinch bolts. Okay, then both pinch axle bolts is loosened. So now we can remove the front axle bolt. And the front axle is loose, and then it's just to remove it and take the wheel out from the bike. And now you should be very carefully with the sensor. There the axle came loose and roll the wheel out from the bike. On each side of the front wheel there are these wheel collars, and before you are reinstalling the front wheel, you should clean them up and apply some grease before you put them back. The collars are equal on both sides. Let us now remount the front wheel to the bike. Roll the wheel back. Be very careful with the ABS sensor. Lift the wheel up a little bit and move the axle through the forks. Like this. Then next operation is to torque the front axle to its specified value, which is 72 newton meters. There it is. And then next is to torque the pinch bolts. And the pinch bolts shall be done in a sequence. And the service manual says that you should first torque number one, then number two, and then number one again. Number one. number two and number one. That's it. Then we have to remount the brake caliper. Let's do that. And these bolts should also be torqued. And the torque values for the front brake caliper bolts is 40 Newton meters. That's it. Before you now go out and ride your bike, be sure to pump up the brake pressure and take it easy the first kilometers until you are sure that everything is fine. Now let us also remove and install the rear wheel. The rear wheel ABS sensor is about here, and it's a 10 millimeter spanner to remove it. So I will now unmount the ABS sensor. And move it out of the way. Like this. So let me put this a little bit out of the way. It's very important that you are not using tools which is magnet when you are working with the ABS sensors. Next thing to do is to undo and remove the rear wheel axle. It is not necessary to first loose the chain tensioner. If you are going to adjust the chain slack, you will have to loosen this 12 millimeter nut and adjust with the 10 millimeter spanner, and then tighten it up again. As I know, will not adjust the chain tension, I just leave the chain tensioner in the position it has on both sides. So now I will remove the 27 millimeter rear wheel axle nut. The nut, the washer, and the adjuster plate. When the axle is loose, it is possible to move the wheel in the front direction to make it possible to remove the chain from the sprocket. Like this. Then it's just to remove the axle and remove the rear wheel. Like this. And the wheel is loose. And also here on the rear wheel, there are collars. There is one collar on the right side at the brake disc, which looks like this, which should be cleaned and grease it before putting it back. On the sprocket side, there is a larger collar, which also should be cleaned
up and grease it before putting it back. The grease around the collars is helping to keep water out from the wheel bearings. So that is important. Now it's possible to remove the crush drive from the rear wheel. But as I know I am not going to change tires, I will now put the rear wheel back again.
Putting the rear caliper about in its correct position, like this, and align the disc rotor to the pads, then rolling the wheel back in. Be careful with the ABS sensor. Look after the collars, that the collars don't fall off, which is very easy. And then put in the rear axle. I would also put some grease on this axle if it was a long time ago I have done this operation. Here is the adjusting plate, and the adjusting plate will point forward with this part of the plate. So now I will put in the axle, and to get the axle in, I will have to lift the wheel a little bit. So, like this. So let me take the axle a little bit out again. Put the wheel all the way forward. Mount the chain like this. Install the adjusting plate like this. Mount the big washer. Mount the nut. Push the wheel forward as far as it goes, so that the adjuster plates is flush with the adjusting nut, and tightening up the rear wheel nut temporarily. We are going to torque it in a minute. Checking that everything looks okay on the right side. The last thing I will do is to remount this ABS sensor. Yes. So there the rear axle nut was torqued to specified value. So the only thing now is to mount the ABS sensor. So let's do that. Check that it is no dirt there. If there is, clean it up. And now mount the bolt. And the bolt should be torqued to 7 newton meters. So that is very little. Yes. Finished mounting the rear wheel.
Do not forget to pump up the pressure to the rear brake caliper before you are going out for a test ride. Just some finishing remarks from me here in my garage. Before you start doing a job like I did, you should secure the bike like I am doing here. When doing this job out in the bush on a long adventure, you will probably not bring with you torque wrenches. So you should practice a little bit with those tools you bring with you to get a feel for the torques. I will put a link in the description of this video to some very handy tools which covers all the nuts and bolts I have shown you in this video. See you in the next one. Bye bye.